as a nation, and this year's census data show that from religion to family, Australia is changing. Joining me now in the studio is social researcher Mark McCrindle. Mark, welcome. Looking at the survey numbers, there are just so many of them, it's hard to know where to start. But let's give it a go. Now, nearly 25.5 million of us filled in this survey, and it seems that millennials are playing a much bigger role in society these days.
That's right. They're now the largest generation in Australia, 5.4 million of them. Mm-hmm. And so they've just taken over the baby boomers for that crown of demographic size. The baby boomers, of course, for more than 50 years have dominated the demographics, and now it's their children that are the ones that we're talking about as they move not only demographically with scale, but economically as they earn and spend and start their own families.
What stands out about them?
Well, firstly, it's that they've been influencing things as the first digital natives. They're called millennials because it was in this new millennium, even though they were born from the 1980s, that they really began to come of age. So from the digital devices to social media to even the learning tools of the digital classroom, that's what was mainstream for them. But now they're having children in a big way. In fact, in the last 10 years, they've had 3 million children, which is more than in the prior 10 years the previous generation had. So children, they're a third of the workforce. So that means they probably pay about a third of the tax as well. So far from being the generation that are students and living the lifestyle, they're making a massive contribution to Australia. One other figure that was interesting was that of all of those who serve in the Australian Defence Forces, 48% of them are millennials. So almost half of those in uniform are this generation that was once derided as, here
snowflakes
for the short term. Exactly. So far from it, they're defending our nation on top of everything else.
Let's talk about where people are coming from. A lot of people coming from afar, but also a pick up in the number of Indigenous Australians or people identifying as Indigenous.
That's right. So cultural diversity continues to define us. More than half of us were either born overseas or had a parent born overseas. So first or second generation migrants is now, what comprises this nation. And it's the biggest source of our growth, our overseas arrivals, notwithstanding closed borders that we've had for a little while, but that will continue to be the future. India has really moved up the ranks. It's now, after Australia and England, it's the next biggest country of birth of someone born overseas. So pretty phenomenal, having leapfrogged China and New Zealand. So big rise there. And as you say, Indigenous Australians has been a growth there as well. So 3.2% of our population are Indigenous, and that's a 25% increase in 5 years in terms of total numbers. So a lot more Indigenous Australians feeling comfortable to share that identity.
Oh, that's really encouraging news. Let's talk about fuel prices. Anyone who's been anywhere near a petrol station in recent months would not have failed to notice that prices have just gone through the roof. And that's going to be impacting people right across Australia.
Yeah, well, that's right. And, it's great to find alternatives like public transport or get rid of a car. But this census data shows us that we are very car reliant. 91% of Australian households have at least one car. In fact, 55% of households, more than half, have two or more. We are a big land. We've got big sprawling cities. Public transport isn't an option for everyone, and particularly juggling roles of childcare and kids at school or multiple jobs for many, indeed most households, they can't get by without that car.
Particularly after the pandemic, I assume a lot of people turning away from public transport during that period. And speaking of the pandemic, that had a real impact on the way the census was filled out this time around. That's a very interesting quirk there.
It is, because of the time that it was last August as we filled it in, most cities were in lockdown, and that is reflected in the data here. It's almost like a time capsule of what the lockdowns was. For example, there were more than 2 million more of us at home on census night than the 2016 census night. There were 500,000 fewer people travelling overseas. We're a nation that loves to travel, but not last year. And indeed, this was fascinating that we had just 60,000 overseas visitors on census night, which is remarkably small for a nation relying on tourism and travel. In fact, the prior census of 2016, we had more than 300,000 overseas visitors on census night. So we really were locked down and bunkering in our homes. 96% of Australians were at home on census night, so we just were not going out last August, and that's the highest ever, and a really high completion rate as well, so that did help the ABS.
No doubt, we were all looking for something to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, Mark McCrindle, thanks so much for joining us tonight.